are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is Monday, the 15th of August, 2022, 20th week in ordinary time. And today we keep the solemnity of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary. The Solemnity of the Assumption celebrates the completion of God's triumph in Mary, the one who had been chosen in a special way to be the Mother of the Lord and of the Church, the one who had been filled with the Holy Spirit at the Annunciation and Pentecost, the one who is full of grace, now lives in the glory of heaven, in body and soul, sharing in the resurrection of Christ. For Pius XII declared the bodily assumption of Mary into heaven as a dogma of the Church in 1950. And in this dogma, the Church teaches that Mary, having completed the course of her earthly life, was assumed body and soul into heavenly glory. This was contained in the Apostolic Constitution, Munificentissimus Deus, by exercising papal infallibility. To avoid all that is uncertain, the Pope did not state either the manner or the circumstances of time and place in which the Assumption took place. Only the fact of the Assumption of Mary, body and soul, into the glory of heaven is the matter of definition. How that took place, we don't know. We want to celebrate this solemnity and to say this is an assurance of our end as well. When you live according to God's will, your end will be a lovely one. Participating in the proclamation of the Word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members: Alice Muchena Fachi, celebrating her birthday today from Mundola, Zambia, text for us the first reading. Kayla Taonga Nyirongo, celebrating her birthday today from Mundola, Zambia, assisted by her family, text for us the responsorial psalm. Lucy Waweru from Makuyu, Kenya, celebrating her 51st birthday, text for us the second reading. Proclaiming the gospel is Father Emmanuel Abiri from Kaduna Archdiocese in Nigeria, as he celebrates his birthday today. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who assumed the Immaculate Virgin Mary, the mother of your Son, body and soul, into heavenly glory, grant, we pray, that always attentive to the things that are above, we may merit to be sharers of our glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
First reading. A woman clothed with the sun, with the moon under her feet. A reading from the book of Revelation. Revelation chapter 11, verse 19a. Chapter 12, verses 1 to 6a and 10ab. God's temple in heaven was opened, and a great sign appeared in heaven. A woman clothed with the sun, with the moon under her feet, and on her head a crown of 12 stars. She was with child, and she cried out in her pangs of birth, in anguish for delivery. And another sign appeared in heaven. Behold, a great red dragon, with 7 heads and 10 horns, and 7 diadems upon his head. His tail swept down a third of the stars of heaven, and cast them to the earth. And the dragon stood before the woman, who was about to bear a child, that he might devour her child when she brought it forth. She brought forth a male child, one who is to rule all the nations with a rod of iron. But her child was caught up to God and to his throne, And the woman fled into the wilderness, where she has a place prepared by God. And I heard a loud voice in heaven saying, Now the salvation and the power and kingdom of our God and the authority of his Christ have come. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Psalm 45 verse 10, 11, 12, 16. Response is from Psalm 45 verse 10b. And the response is, On your right stands the queen in God of Ophir. The daughters of kings are those who you favor. On your right stands the queen in God of Ophir. On your right stands the queen in God of Ophir. Listen, O daughter, pay heed and give ear. Forget your own people and your father's house. On your right stands the queen in God of Ophir. So will the king desire your beauty. He is Lord. Pay homage to him. On your right stands the queen in God of Ophir. They are escorted amid gladness and joy. They pass within the palace of the king. On your right stands the queen in God of Ophir.
Second reading. Christ the first fruits, then those who belong to Christ. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 20 to 27. Brethren, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For as by a man came death, by a man has come also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, so also in Christ shall all be made alive. But each in his own order, Christ the first fruits, then at his coming those who belong to Christ. Then comes the end, when he delivers the kingdom to God the Father, after destroying every rule and every authority and power. For he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death, for God has put all things in subjection under his feet. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
He who is mighty has done great things for me. He has exalted those of low degree. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Luke chapter 1, verse 39 to 56. In those days, Mary arose and went with haste into the hill country to a city of Judah, and she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. And when Elizabeth heard the greeting of Mary, the child leaped in her womb. And Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit, and she exclaimed with a loud cry, Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why is it granted me that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For behold, when the voice of your greeting came to my ears, the child in my womb leaped for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her from the Lord. And Mary said, My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has regarded the low estate of his handmaiden. For behold, henceforth all generations will call me blessed. For he who is mighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. And his mercy is from those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He has put down the mighty from their thrones and exalted those of low degree. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent empty away. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, as he spoke to our fathers, to Abraham and his posterity forever. And Mary remained with her about 3 months and returned to her home. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Happy Solemnity of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Assuming Mary into heaven, body and soul just tells us about something. This is a woman who participated in our own redemption by her yes to God. And because of her yes, she indeed proved victorious, and she indeed proved that she can help God in fighting the battles of life. Our earthly life is a battle between forces of death and forces of life. The forces of life are constantly at war with the forces of death, and we have so many forces of death in our world today. There are so many who are battling against life in our world today. And Mary shows that that is the work that is given to her, to battle those forces of evil. We see that in the first reading of today. A great sign appearing in heaven. A woman who was clothed with the sun representing the forces of life, with the moon under her feet, the moon representing the forces of death. Whatever advocates death, the fight for drugs to continue existing in this world, the drugs that destroy people and end up confusing them and leading to death, a fight against all those who call themselves pro-choice. They are calling themselves pro-choice because they choose death rather than life. On the side of those who fight for life, the sun represents those who advocate for family values, those who advocate for communal values, those who fight individualism and want the society to remain a society that respects human life, a society that respects the rights of others. Against those who are under the influence of the moon, we call them lunatics. And the world is full of lunatics. The world is full of those who indeed are against anything that is done during the day. They are advocates of darkness. They are advocates of death. And Mary is stepping on these forces. She is stepping on the forces of evil. She is stepping on the forces of darkness, on the forces of death. Because she's carrying somebody. She's carrying Jesus Christ, the Son, the one who proves victorious, the one who has come to destroy all these forces of evil. And Assumption crowns it all. It is because she fights with God, she fought with God, by our obedience to the word, that she's able to be in the glory of the Father. She gets up, goes to her cousin Elizabeth, and as she gets closer to the house, we see things changing. Everything is affected by her presence. The child in the womb of Elizabeth leaped for joy. The child in the womb of Elizabeth started proclaiming the greatness of the Lord. This is the woman who tells us what our visits must be to one another. When we go to our family members, we must arouse the Holy Spirit in them, not the demon, not the evil spirits. Now that depends on the vibes we carry with us. That depends on the message we take to others. If we are only taking gossip, if we are only taking distraction to others, if we are only going to share discriminatory statements with others, if we are only going to tell people how bad the life we are living is, then we are not going to make them have the Holy Spirit in them. We are not going to make them proclaim life. They are going to proclaim death. We are going to shorten their lifespan because of the negative things that we share with them. Mary went to share the good news. She went to alert Elizabeth, for Elizabeth to understand that she's the Ark of the Covenant. She has brought this covenant to the family of Elizabeth. She has brought this renewed understanding so that Elizabeth may be filled with more life and understand that God is at work. The Elizabeth who was almost giving up hope is filled with new life and is able to dance for joy. And because she was able to dance for joy, even the child in her womb danced for joy. That is exactly the power of influence of a woman. A mother has so much power to influence the character of a child. What you do as a mother will affect in a positive way or in a negative way the child that you bear. If you are a joyful woman, if you are a positive thinker, that child is going to be a motivational speaker because the child experienced that joy, that positivity from the womb. So be careful, my dear mother. Be careful how you conduct yourself while you are pregnant, because that is going to affect your child. Mary made this pregnant woman to jump for joy, and the two children, the great children in the womb, also started communicating with each other. Jesus was communicating with John. They were talking about the mission they were going to accomplish. It is good for pregnant mothers to be together. Pregnant mothers must share their closeness so that the children can talk about the mission God has given them here on earth, so that they can define their own mission, which is already set by God from the womb. He called me before I was born. He called my name from the womb of my mother. The prophets have made known to us that God starts communicating to us from the womb. So you are special not because of the job you have. You are special not because of the husband or wife you have. You are special because from the womb you were commissioned. Mary, the Ark of the Covenant, recognizing what great things the Lord had done in her life, was able to sing the Magnificat, that powerful hymn. The hymn that shows the war that is there between forces of darkness, forces of the moon, and forces of the light, the sun. We see the contrast. It puts down the proud from their thrones and raises up the lowly who belong to the sun, who belong to light, are raised up. And she declares, "From now on, all generations will call me blessed." And this is what is happening. All generations have been calling Mary blessed, unless you don't understand her role, or unless you are just jealous. I see my Muslim brothers and sisters celebrating the assumption. It is there in the Quran. I see them respecting only one woman. It is only one woman who has been mentioned at length in the Quran, Maryam. That is the only woman who has three chapters dedicated to her in the Quran to show that indeed all generations will call her blessed, because her role was not small, because her role was designed by God. And if you don't respect her role, then you don't respect the design of God in anyone's life. We give glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Monday to you, and happy Solemnity of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary.
Thanks be to God.
Holy Queen enthroned above, oh my.